In this video, we will be discussing the ins and outs of customer service. The primary goal of all employees at the rec center is to provide great customer service to all members and visitors. When dealing with members and visitors, we expect all employees to be kind, courteous, and act in an agreeable manner. When firmness is needed, we ask that you're still pleasant with the customers. Now let's look at some situations around the rec center and see if we can improve our customer service. Let's debrief. Here, Ricky can improve his customer service by not chewing gum. He can also have a small meal, but not a large meal. Members might wonder why Ricky's allowed to eat downstairs when they're not allowed to have food downstairs. Ricky can have his small meal downstairs because he may not have the opportunity to eat between class and work. Prior to eating at work, he got approval from the Assistant Director of Aquatics and Student Development. He can also improve his customer service by placing his beverage underneath the table so it's out of sight. By doing all of these things, Ricky will definitely improve his customer service.
Oh no!
Let's debrief. Ricky can improve his customer service here by placing all of his personal belongings in the cubbies at customer service prior to working. This allows for the ECO desk to be clean and not cluttered so that he is easily accessible for all customers.
Excuse me, can you check me in, please? Hello? Please, I really want to go work out.
Let's debrief. Ricky can improve his customer service by putting his homework away. If you remember correctly, doing homework while at work will result in 3 discipline points. Homework is not permitted during the academic year, but homework is permitted during certain occasions, including Thanksgiving break, Easter break, spring break, and summer break.
Hi, welcome to the rec center. There you go. Hey, yeah, what's up?
Excuse me.
Hey, yeah, oh, yeah, yeah.
I really want to check in. I want to work out, please.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Excuse me. Excuse me.
Let's debrief. Cell phones should not be used at work. Prior to coming to work, you should turn off your cell phone and store it with your personal items at customer service. If a cell phone is seen at work, it is assumed that it's being used and you will be given 2 discipline points. In order to keep the rec center lines open, we also ask that no personal calls are made from the area phones. If you do have a personal emergency that you need to make a phone call for, please inform the facility manager prior to your shift.
Hey, Ashley, can you come to customer service and cover? I have to make a personal phone call.
Sometimes our members have grievances about our policies and procedures. You may be approached by a member with suggestions or concerns. Let's see how Ricky responds to a customer.
Sorry, sir, but that's not proper workout attire. Richard, right?
Yeah.
Richard?
Yeah.
I have a membership here. I come in here every day. I just got off of work. All I want to do is come in, play some basketball, blow off some steam, and now you're telling me I can't work out in here?
Yeah, I understand you just got off work, but it's not safe.
So you understand?
Yeah.
You understand, so I should be able to come in here and play basketball since you understand.
No, I understand that you just got off work, but it's our policy that I can't let you work out in that.
How is this unsafe? How is this unsafe? Like, what am I doing to harm other people in my dress clothes right now?
It's just not proper workout attire, sir. We have it clearly listed in our rules. If you'd like, I could call my manager.
Yes. Show me the rules. Show me your manager. Show me the rules. I want to see that.
Okay, I'll call my manager and she'll try to clarify this for you.
This is ridiculous.
Hey, Ashley.
Let's debrief about what Ricky did correctly. First, Ricky was nice, courteous, and professional. Second, Ricky acknowledged the customer's feelings and tried to understand them. Third, Ricky paraphrased what the facts were being said to him. Additionally, Ricky did a great job not getting caught up in their behavior or letting their behavior become the problem. This customer gave Ricky some verbal abuse, but Ricky did a great job of ignoring it. Ricky focused on finding a solution to the problem, and even though he couldn't find an answer, he did the right thing by asking a facility manager to come and help him find the solution to the problem. Together as a team, they were able to please the customer.